Hello, it's Icy. I'm back with the next part of my Mass Effect playthrough. I'm going to stop saying what number I'm up to because, honestly, I keep getting that number wrong. Ascent is go. It's the first time I've left a planet.
All clear.
The Atmo, hey, Suvi. Now, I should do a few things. While I'm in space, in my ship, I should go and talk to everybody in my ship, and I should see if I can give different gear to my companions, because I don't know that yet. Because I've got that great force glove that I want to give to maybe Cora? Probably?
Before the meeting gets started, I have bunk assignments for PB and Drac.
Okay.
Already put my rucksack in the kitchen. I'll hang out there if that's okay.
And I'm in one of the escape pods. More my speed. That's fantastic.
Nice, Cora.
Any thoughts, Ryder?
Whatever. It's cool.
You're professionals. I'm not going to babysit bunk assignments. Let's talk about our success on Eos. Besides establishing our first viable outpost, we did some amazing things. We discovered the Remnant and breached their vault.
And didn't get
so cool.
Killed.
That too.
Overcame radiation poisoning.
Several times.
And didn't die. Confronted by Ket at every turn.
Once again, did not get killed.
You guys really need to raise the bar on what you call success.
Ah, oh, screw you, Drac.
Should we use the Krogan definition of success?
No, Cora. Cora. Back off.
Fair enough.
Let's focus. Back to the task at hand. Looking forward. Exactly. Here's my only question. When do we hit that next vault? It looked active. We have to get on that.
Mm-hmm. Hang on. We need to not go off half-cocked.
There are initiative priorities. The team calls the shots.
Actually, the Pathfinder calls the shots, just to be clear.
Oh, thank you, Cora.
So what do you need from us, Ryder?
Work hard or get along? I want you to work hard.
Helios threw us for a loop, meaning we're kind of new at this. All of us. So let's figure out what the rules are now and try to stick to them.
Sounds good.
If there's one thing I know I can do, it's make up rules.
No one said make up rules. Can we please keep anarchy to a minimum?
Ooh.
Okay, let's head back to the Nexus. PB, Drac, see Lexi for a physical? Good meeting, everyone.
Oh, I love how that just sort of petered out and it didn't work real well. Awesome. All right, let's find out more about augmentations. That we kind of here am I going, I don't know how to craft. Nothing's telling me how to craft. I've got tutorials in the game. All right. Navigating the menu. Look, honestly, the menu is terrible. Using augmentation, blueprints rank 2 or higher. Basically, just put it in and then craft it. Anything else in here that I need to read? Combat, cover powers, aerial, maybe blah, 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 blah. Blah, blah. Invulnerability, port stations, nomad, world map, blah, blah. Loadout, weight and mods. Yeah, tell me more about this. Okay. Weapon weight. Okay. Recharge times. Okay. Combat fitness can increase your weight capacity. Oh, okay. So it could be worthwhile. And certain mods reduce the weight of the guns. Okay. So it could be worthwhile to look at combat fitness too as an option. Okay, finding minerals. Yes, I need some more minerals. Mining zones, mining computers, mining drones. Yep. Oh, so I can put lots and then basically have their circles. Okay, so I should maybe do more drones then. Okay, that's interesting. I'll remember that for next time. Research, we worked out that. Craft. Development, that's to actually make the weapons. And yes, okay. Remnant interfacing. Click E. Decryption. Yeah, we did that one. Strike teams. Okay. All right, well, I think we read everything there. Okay, so what have we got here? VidCon. No calls. Alrighty. How's Scott doing, I wonder? Let's go talk to everybody.
I'm in the galley when you're free.
Sure, Drac. Sounds good. I'll come talk to you in a minute. I'm not even sure where I am. Nice. Oh, here we go. Found.
Clean air, plants, helps me think.
Something you alright, Cora?
Maybe.
Whoa.
What the hell was that? I know that look. It's just my biotics reacting to all this.
Oh, okay.
I don't normally lose it like that. A Huntress should have better control. Huntress? Another term
Tell me
for
more.
An Asari commando. I was one before the initiative. Some things stick, though. Like losing the old man.
Okay. Tell me about the Asari commandos.
How does a human soldier get to serve with Asari? Prove your biotics can rip an APC apart, and people get nervous. Funny that. The Alliance found me a cross-species military initiative in a hurry. Sent me to Thessia to serve with the Huntress unit.
Oh, that's cool.
One of the few places where my powers were welcomed. Your father made another one.
Did you know Deadwell?
You were his second in command. Were you friends too?
A bit more than that,
I
think.
More a mentor than a friend. Prickly old bastard. But I respected that. People treat geniuses like they're made of cut glass. I didn't care how smart he was. I think he liked someone not caring.
Okay. Well, I'm still here.
I know it's not the same, but I'm a good listener. I hope you're as good at being Pathfinder. I said I wouldn't get in the way, and I meant it. But I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he
chooses
you.
I know.
An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
Oh, I don't.
Is this going to be a problem, Cora?
Yeah, is it going to be a problem?
Rival. Just answers.
I don't want a rival either.
Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then
it's
maybe
my
we'll
mission
all
now.
Get what we came out here for.
We'll be good together. No. She was my father's number two. Perhaps in more ways than one. I don't think so. What did you come here for? It won't be easy. What did you come here for?
So what brought you out to Andromeda? Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari Huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was
That's
meant
not
to
helpful.
Be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through.
Okay.
It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark. If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise. If you want to talk, I'll be here.
Okay, so her... Whoop! Where's my point of view? There it is. Okay, so her point of view, her loyalty mission is going to be the Asari. Okay, that's cool. Let's find some other people to talk to. We gotta talk to everybody! What's over this side? Anybody? Anybody? Nope. Might be for my one... Oh, wait! Where was my... Oh, strike team missions, yes. Oh! Online features can... I am connected online? What the... Alright, hang on. Alright, I'm just gonna cut here. And work out... Why it doesn't think I'm online? Wait... Okay, I'm back. But that's not where I saved. Wait, did I talk to Cor? That was weird. I saved that. Oh, maybe it wasn't a real save.
Ryder?
Oh. Okay, I can talk to him more.
What did you
okay,
do
that's
while
fine.
You were part of the Asari military?
So I had the conversation
Four
had worked.
Years in a commando unit called Ta-Lane's Daughters. Part of the Council's cross-species military integration initiative. Your time defending Silva's expedition was probably more important.
But we did good work. Peacekeeping is a full-time job, even in a sorry space.
What was your
commando unit like?
Janae and I were the youngsters. Tethys was our old lady sniper. Kalia patched us up.
Tethys, right name.
Between firefights. Our CO, Nasira, led us all over the Athena Nebula and beyond. A Huntress's work is never done.
Every civilization needs its defenders.
Mm-hmm.
And the defenders usually match their civilization. Like Asari Huntress's being adaptable as hell. Makes you wonder what our militia will look like in 100 years.
Okay, tell me more about your military career.
You were in the Alliance before you became a Huntress, right? What made you join up?
My biotics. I was still living on my parents' cargo freighter when they manifested. Untrained biotic power on a starship means accidents. But we couldn't afford a tutor. The Alliance had implants, the training, everything.
Mm.
Old history now. Your turn. Remind me why you came to Andromeda.
The Prothean digs woke us up to how much we don't know. And to what humanity.
Oh, I'd love a choice option there, actually.
Dad's career collapsed. His AI research made him too toxic.
I heard. Must have changed everything for your family.
We needed a fresh start. I dreamed of discovery.
I wanted to find worlds and secrets no one had ever seen. And Scott was itching for adventure. So, Andromeda.
None of you writers ever think small, do you?
Nope.
Did you come out here with anyone? Maybe someone you served with?
I had my fun on shore leave. Nothing serious, though. Asari Huntresses figure things out, but I was there for soldiering, not romance.
How do they figure it out? What?
Does that mean fraternization is okay for Asari Commandos?
It'll happen, but usually only for one deployment. Asari don't usually stay with each other long term. After your 500th birthday, you learn some self-control.
All right. Tell me some war stories.
4 years with Asari Commandos? You must have some great war stories.
Nasira assassinated a Krogan warlord with a pack of playing cards once.
A pack of cards?
Choking hazard.
Wow.
Okay, tell me more about the Ark.
Search for the Asari Ark going.
You're going to just ask, but...
Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
Okay.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Alright, so I am now online. So I think maybe if I wait before getting in the game till it when it switches from connected to actually my login, I think then it will count me as being online. Here we go. Alright, so... Oh, I've got a debrief. It's from last time I was on the space station. Ooh, good. Wait. Okay, so they got these Apex missions. See, they're the ones that... oh, actually, these ones expire on completion. Ooh. Tempted to maybe go in and try some... PV. It's not quite PvP, but yeah. Alright, let's have a look. 70% chance of success. Sounds good. Actually, should take a long one. What time is it? It's an hour and a half. Alright, let's have a look. 5%. Oh, I see that's a 5-hour mission. 5%. 70%. 0.8 of an hour. Oh, that sounds pretty good. Key. Nope. All right, let's do that one. Sweet. Excellent. Oh, I see. That little symbol in my map view meant that the strike mission had finished. Okay. Oh. All right. Claim rewards. I got some credits. And... a bronze... Oh, magnesium. Sweet. Alright, anything else? Oh, I can recruit teams. Okay. Positive traits that exceed negative ones if they fail. Oh. Oh, can I not do it maybe while the mission is running? Okay, so I can equip teams with stuff. Okay, that's cool. And I've got some mission funds. Huh. Alright, that sounds cool.
Strike team ready for deployment.
So we just deployed them. No. Yep, we did. Okay, so... Alright, so we need to talk to everybody. We need to talk to Drac. We need to talk... Okay, we need to talk to Cora. Sorry, not Cora. Vetra. Okay.
Pathfinder, making the rounds.
Yes.
Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out.
Slumming it?
Hey, this is the most important part of the ship.
Whoa, don't tell me they put someone smart in charge for a change.
Possibly.
I am at your command.
Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now.
Okay.
It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
Oh. Interesting.
Seems like life back there was pretty bleak.
Not gonna lie, it sucked. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and... Oops. I just made a decision there's no turning back from.
I'll say.
I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
Well, help you find purpose? I'll do more than show up. It's too early. It's too early.
We're exploring this cluster. Eventually, the galaxy. If your purpose is here, we'll find it.
Then the question will be, what will I do with it? In the meantime, you just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Deal. Okay, so, a little point I want to talk about here. Now, this is a BioWare game. It's all about romancing your crewmates. I will just say, though, it's kind of vaguely creepy in a HR kind of way that as the... basically the commander, can anybody say no? Do you know what I mean? Like if even if they're saying yes, can you be sure? I'm sure people are saying no just because they'll say no, but if they're saying yes, can you be sure they're saying yes for the right reasons? You know, it's just one of those things. Just feels awkward sometimes. Oh, cool. Alright, I'm back. Let's go talk to Vetra.
Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
And who's Sid?
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Ryder, this is Sid, my sister. Sid, Ryder.
Younger sister, right?
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look,
cool.
You know, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I'd love an explanation. Actually, I would love an explanation.
Now's as good a time as any.
Tell me more.
I think... No. I know that I can be of use here. I know everyone on the crew. Even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I
That's
know
good.
How to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
You're intense. I like it.
Wow, that's some laser focus.
Yeah? Was it too much? Some people get intimidated.
I'm not just some people. I really like the intensity.
That's good. It's nice to feel appreciated.
Oh, is it too much?
I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know.
Yeah? But tell me more about yourself.
We'll chat later.
Okay. And then was I saying it's creepy to hit on people when you're the in command?
Terraforming, Atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving, and everyone hates moving. Packing alone.
Point taken. I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
Plan's the same. We find a home. Whatever that takes.
Keep that drive. Makes me believe we can make it. I mean, we have to make it. The alternative is not even worth thinking about.
Tell me more about you, Vetra.
On the Nexus when the revolt happened?
When you promise people golden worlds and all they get are wastelands and a death cloud, they riot.
Mm.
Some wanted to go home, some demanded answers, and a couple just wanted to stir shit up.
And you?
Some days I wondered if the exiles had a point. Maybe we were conned into coming here.
Mm.
But why would the initiative go to all this trouble just to screw us over?
Yeah.
Thing about conning people, you always know something they don't. And that's why the con works. And if I'm going to pick a side, I'm picking the liars.
Hmm. Interesting. So she doesn't trust the top level at all.
Channels. What did you mean?
We brought a lot from home. Some of it marked initiative, some of it in personal caches. Most things you want, someone's got. You just have to figure out who and what they're willing to take in exchange.
Predatory? Too easy.
It can't be that simple.
Hmm.
Oh, but it is. Most things are simple once you know the trick to them.
How do you join the initiative?
How did you hear of the Andromeda Initiative?
Short answer, Cash. She was looking for some experimental ship mods, and I knew how to track them down.
Cool.
I thought it was a one-time deal, but she came back. Once, twice. Eventually, I figured out something was going on. Something big, with creds behind it. I asked and she told me about the initiative. New galaxy, new home. Couldn't pass that up.
Anyone's...
Have anyone else here with you? Besides Cid?
No, just me and Cid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh. You mean like... Oh. No, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Yeah, no time.
Like you said, who has time?
Eventually things will settle down a bit. Hopefully. Or we'll be dead. Anyway.
I'll let you go.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Oh, I think I like Vetra. I think I like Vetra. Alright, who else do I need to talk to? Okay, who's in here? This Drax? No. This is Liam and his couch.
I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable.
Okay.
Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked omni-blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Did that sentence make sense?
Right, right. What?
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So.
Oh, right.
Time for that beer?
sure.
After 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your alliance days much?
What was Hustle?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy Urban Search Terrain 1?
Yeah. Oh.
Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit.
Cool.
HUST-1, but Hustle looks much better on the patch.
All fair enough. All
civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded.
Why aren't you wearing a beard now?
Tastes better just
too hard to animate. Hmm. I don't think about that time.
I put it behind me after Dad's work went sour. It was a long time ago.
And she's like, what, 18?
Years, give or take.
21, so, maybe? 24?
Why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
Yeah. Come to let me know. I need to leave that life? Opportunity. Love of science.
I started in the Alliance, but it was the science that kept me going. And when that ended, well, if I wanted to be a part of the next big discovery, it had to be here.
Oh, I don't hear idealist a lot. Everyone's cynical.
Hmm.
Back at you, Costa. Why do you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story.
Quite a lot of people have heard that already.
But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the
apart from the odd shoulders. You should have got those operated on before you left.
I believe in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
It puts a lot of pressure on all of us. We could change direction. What else would we do with the initiative apart from... It's just say pressure.
If it all goes wrong, it could feel like we left for no reason.
I know why I'm here. A bad start can't change that. I won't let it. In crisis response, I'd focus on essentials. That's you and this team. Pathfinder leads to planets, leads to people. You've got your part covered. You've got this.
Thanks, Liam.
I'll do my damnedest to help with the rest.
All right. Thanks, mate. That's helpful. All right. Oh, actually, I suppose let's do a second talk. See if there's anything extra.
Prodromos.
Prodromos. Thanks for reminding me what it was.
We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
I'm interested in you. That's pretty blunt. Tell me more about you.
Barely covered how you joined. Tell me.
See, I obviously missed the first round of conversations before we got here.
I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it all been done.
Okay.
I wasn't looking to start over. I wanted to start big.
Okay, Korea.
You were a cop, then crisis response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did.
Well,
but it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
You as a cop sounds a cliche. No, it sounds satisfying.
You found your place. Not everyone gets that.
I knew it. Glad for it every day. And that led me here.
Okay.
Tell me about your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does.
Yeah.
Mom, Joelle. Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional. How about you?
Non-traditional? Who defines traditional?
Traditional is a weird term for family. Like, normal. Who's that describe?
Yeah.
I suppose you're right. I sure didn't keep the tradition. I said goodbye to my mom and dad, and got on a ship to Andromeda.
True.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Because what else are you going to do in the ship? Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, you think of these people, and it's like the people who, you know, got on a ship. Not the first settlers. Well, sorry, the first settlers, as opposed to the first arrivals in Australia, who were convicts, who, you know, got on a ship and left everything in order to come somewhere, be something, enjoy a life they couldn't have. All right, what have we got? Dinner. Soup. Fruit cocktail for Vetra. Okay, coffee mug. Magnetized base. He's stuck it sideways on the wall. Oh, Drake and PB are officially on the team. Cool. And Drake, I just wanted to check in publicly about what I said. Cora, relax, Harper. The best headbutt is always the one you don't... Okay. Interesting. Okay. I would like to register an objection that one bathroom for how many people are on here? 8 people is not enough. Plus, I don't know what Krogans or Vetra or anybody require, and I'm not sure a Krogan would fit inside that cubicle. So I just want to let you know I'm not sure about that. And I've decided that I don't like the orange. We just make everything black. Because that's how I roll. And I did it again, and I don't know how this What? Come on. Okay. We go back to here first? No. I don't know how that works. I managed to get it to work before. No. No, now you're working. Maybe it's buggy. Ugh. Okay, fine. I don't play around in that. Okay, so I found a, did I find a model of the Hyperion? And where did I stick it? Why do I have so much alcohol? Email terminal. Oh, here we go. Sam should be able to research. Discuss in person the Nexus Labs. Okay, acknowledge. Brothers McCoy. The family pendants are good. Excellent, good. Okay, archive that one. Okay, Cora, thanks for talking. I don't feel better. They do feel better, but they're not fixed yet. Work's important. Grief and fuel. Okay. Plants and I are coming along. Botany. Blah. The vault. Two rider from Cora. Still smell that remnant vault of my armor. Lots of weird shit down there. Now I think back, it reminded me of some of the temples on Thessia. Same spacious, same huge running water. Same sense of purpose you can't understand. Okay. Tempest hacks. Cool. Give all to Omni tools. What a temperature override. Cool. Jump wash cue. Put Awesome. Thanks, Kello. Hey, Pathfinder. From Liam.
No place I'd rather be.
Why a joint hustle? We'll do it! Liam has included a list of media themed to frontiers. Genres include Western, space, opera, and oddly, Tyrian historical dramas. Cool! You're the boss. I know I said something about back channel doing what I have to do. Being on the Nexus during the bad times, it got us used to a lot of ugly things because survival isn't that pretty. That might be one problem. Alright, about your dad. From Drac. Vera told me what happened to your dad. I could use some cheering up. He's attached 37 images of rifles and shotguns. Okay, thanks, Drac. Yoga poses. Who's this from? Lexi. Okay, she thinks I should have 10 to 15 minutes a day to stretch and open your... Open your hips. I don't think that opening the hips is a problem for any of the characters in this game. I think the hips are very, very open. True, humans invented yoga, but they are sorry, perfected. I have done some yoga. I am not by any means an expert, but yes, I could probably do... Could I do all of these? I'm not that flexible, but I would know the poses. Cool. And interviews. Okay, we need to talk to her still. Alright, that's funny. Oh, look at the little... Oh, that's so cute! Oh, let's talk to Sam. Hello, oh, look, and there's the ships.
Has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted.
Uh-huh.
But you succeeded on Eos, despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star.
Really?
You have grown as a result, and so have I.
Oh. Okay, tell me more,
is
Sam.
Is it confusing to be in multiple places talking to different people?
My awareness can be partitioned, so I can give you the same attention as, say, a SAM node technician. In the field, you are my primary focus, and all other requests are queued. In the vernacular, you have my undivided attention.
Cool, okay. Memory triggers.
Sam, any more information on the memory trigger we found?
The memory blocks are still in place. If you continue searching for more triggers, they may unlock.
Okay, Your location.
Are you still on the Hyperion?
Yes. This terminal provides a direct link to my servers in Samnode on the Ark. I can maintain a presence on the Tempest via quantum entanglement communication.
Convenient. That's useful.
I'm sure that'll come in handy.
As I remain in touch with you and the Pathfinder team at all times.
So, quantum entanglement is an actual known scientific phenomena. You should look it up, but it's not able to be used for communications at this stage by a long way. So, Scott.
What was Dad's take on Scott and I?
He believed your family
brought
you closer together and hoped that would endure. It appears that hope was well founded.
Oh, okay. That's good. Humor.
So if we're going to work together, you might notice I like to joke around sometimes, lighten things up. How's your sense of humor, Sam?
Alec Ryder encouraged me to develop this skill.
Okay.
Humor's not a skill, it's... Okay, try telling me a joke.
Go for it.
A neutron enters a bar and asks, how much is a drink? The bartender replies, for you, no charge.
Boom,
I can see why Dad told you to keep working on your humor. Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
That's a good dad joke. Alright, so we read my email. There's some of my ships and things I picked up. And obviously I got a lot of shelves in order to collect to the bits and pieces. Alright. Okay, so that's my room.
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh.
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
No, trouble is ideal. We like trouble here.
Welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
True.
I like the way you think, kid.
Ugh, someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
It's hard to be on your own.
Leaving the Nexus can't have been an easy choice.
It was, actually. Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
What about Kesh?
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Roshan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to.
True.
As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
I understand why you left.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that.
Hospitable with a gun. Alright. Let's talk to him again.
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for Kesh ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
Ooh, I would love to.
Got any stories or advice to share?
Does a pyjack scratch its butt?
I don't want
anything
to know.
About the cat? Or combat in general?
Well, Com and Ket are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
More combat advice.
Tell me more about fighting Ket.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like to ghost up behind you when you least expect it. Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming at you.
Oh, good.
Break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
Okay, that's grayed out, so let's talk about other stuff. Alright, tell me about the Kesh.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh
is
not
my
Ket.
Roshan, child of my blood. Raised her myself.
Oh, so more like your daughter.
Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
I like her.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Okay, Sam,
did
why can I...
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Oh, okay,
yeah.
That's why.
You want to hook that thing up to my comms, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why?
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah, my peacekeeping career went up in smoke when news of what my dad was researching got out.
Mm. No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Ow.
Almost.
But Sam and I are a package deal.
Sam is part of what makes someone a Pathfinder. You're just going to have to deal with that.
Mm-hmm.
So long as it's not in my head and it ain't messing with my body.
So, interestingly, in Mass Effect 3, slight spoilers here, fast forward for a couple of minutes if you don't want to know, there are three different endings. You may have heard some of the controversy. So there's the... And one of the endings is called Synthesis, where you... The AIs and the organics merge. And that has always been my choice. Even after they released the, you know, all the extra ending and beautiful closing off, which I really appreciated, I still chose the Synthesis ending the second time. So for me, having Sam integrated... It's kind of like continuing that Synthesis in Andromeda. Tell me more about you, Drac.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
Combat experience?
Oh, about all this combat experience you have.
It's going to be another long video.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have.
Are you a sniper?
I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit. Well over 1,000 years.
Wow, okay.
Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck.
Mm-hmm.
And a really hard head.
Cool. Tell me about Vetra.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late.
Yeah, should have brought me in early.
Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
Yes.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were
Is he making do with me? Oh, well.
She swiped supplies I was trying to get for cash right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
Yeah.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
That's awesome.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clans.
Oh, I wonder if you don't.
Scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up.
Cool.
Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable. The works. Even some farming.
Good.
Farming? Krogan farm?
How else are they gonna eat?
Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Korkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
Okay, any more questions? Oh, tell me about the Nexus Uprising. And I wonder if you don't romance Vetra, which obviously seems an option, does she and this guy, she and Drac get together? That'd be funny. Nexus Uprising.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal.
So history repeating itself.
So we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
You worried about her?
You think someone might try to hurt Kesh?
More like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back and then she airlocks him. Dan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny.
Ooh.
I had no proof.
We've got to get him
so
off the ship.
My part in this?
Things need to get sorted out and my clan needs to get back on station without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
Alrighty.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Do you call everyone kid?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Well, you did just say he was 1,000 years old.
My age? Yeah, pretty much.
Cool. cool. Okay. Excellent. 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 All right. So that was the kitchen. Try not to eat everything. Bathroom. My room. Have we explored everything down here? The med bay. No.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away?
A little more action-packed than Harry bargained for.
He decided to spend. I missed talking to everybody before I left here. After your brother. Okay, welcome aboard.
Happy to have you, Dr. DePero.
I'll do my best.
Considering I've already been talking to Lexi on the planet.
Now? Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
You'll be great.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days. I always hoped to work in the field.
That's great.
Everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy... A live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
You can't have a live subject on
here.
Why
do you care about the
cat? Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy.
I wish I'd known this before I went down.
Is what got me in the initiative.
Oh. Okay. Interesting.
That's a very specific topic.
I grew up on Omega, lots of Krogan mercenaries.
Okay.
The best habitat outside T'Chunka. But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan.
Okay.
Right.
Just something to think about.
Sure. Now,
make sure the Pathfinder eats her vegetables.
Thanks. All right, come back. Come back. I have to talk to you a second time.
Saw we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
Yeah, tell me more.
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
Okay, tell me more.
How did you get into medicine?
My mum was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights. Discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
Crew morale.
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality.
Good.
Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
Okay. Tell me about the non-humans. PB.
Is PB all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
All right, Keller.
How's our Solarian?
He's quite.
I have to go and talk to him as well.
Tight-lipped about himself, though.
Is Drac good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Oh, sure thing.
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe don't mention I asked.
Oh, is there a bit of a romance going on? Okay.
Thanks for the insight.
Oh, no, crew morale. I need
to... How do you think the crew is holding up?
Humans.
Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
Tell me about the sorting.
Why do you sort them that way?
Yeah.
Just easier for me to see patterns in behavior.
Okay. All right.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Okay. Tell me about Cora first.
Oh,
so much talking.
Your father was her mentor. She expected to follow in his footsteps.
Yeah.
But he gave the role of Pathfinder to you.
Yeah, that
just
was kind of...
Just because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused. Or hurt.
Yeah.
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique.
Not that we've met anybody in Mass Effect. He's got that kind of mechanism before.
Sylvie okay?
She's remarkably adaptive. I'm kind of jealous.
Okay, Liam?
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new. Liam's we can't lose attitude is commendable. But I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
All right.
Thanks for the insight.
Okay, memory fragments.
I need to talk to you about something private.
Okay.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
When Dad died, he blocked off parts of Sam's memory. Things he didn't want me to see.
Or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe. I found this trigger. It unlocked a memory fragment of Dad on the Citadel. From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
Because it was a turning point?
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
Yeah. Thanks, Lexi. Feels good to talk about this.
That's it? Okay, friendship with Harry.
How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis.
Ah!
We met at a medical convention on the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
So how did an Asari doctor end up on the human arc?
Yeah.
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember?
Oh yeah, fair enough.
That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
Interesting.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Okay. Thanks. Oh. Respec. I don't think we need to respec myself or anybody else. Alright, so we talked to everybody here. Where are we gonna go? I think we have to go back upstairs now, do we? Yes. Who haven't we talked to? We haven't spoken to Callow? And is that it? I think it might be, actually.
We haven't really spoken since orientation, have we?
And Suvi.
It's all been so hectic, but I'm sure things will quiet down soon. Can't be worse than the Nexus.
Okay. Have they been in these rooms? Oh! The loadout station. Okay, that's to get off the ship. Okay. Come back there in a minute. Email terminal. Same one? Different one. Oh, in case you're interested. Oh, here we go. The thesis. Oh, okay. Oh, good. Okay. Alright, I'll leave that one there. Great. So after you speak to people, you get emails from them as a follow-up. Let's talk to Suvi.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
It does have beauty.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon. Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
Oh. A god?
You mean a god? Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
Oh. It's very blunt. It's a very blunt choice. You either go, I feel the same way, or there's no higher power. There's no, that's nice, or I'm not sure. I haven't seen evidence either way. Interesting.
There's nothing about the universe that suggests a divine intelligence. And most of what we've seen in Helios is artificial, as you said yourself. Yes, but we're creative beings. Whoever made the Remnant was too. Why should that be proof against a god? Wouldn't a true creator want to pass on the drive to invent?
Leave what you want. That's very... Yeah.
If everything was set in place by some mysterious creator, why even be a scientist?
Nobody said it was set in place.
If I had reverence for a creator, how could I not want to study their creation?
Yeah?
My faith does not hinder my work as a scientist. It encourages it. My senses tell me what the world is. Science shows me how it came to be. And religion tells me why.
have it in event.
I apologize if I offended you. I can be insensitive.
You're fine. Being challenged forces me to...
Yeah, there's no middle option there.
No, I should
see that, yes, I agree, or aggressively I don't, as opposed to, you are entitled to your beliefs. Interesting. Alright. Let's just see. What's the second conversation?
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is. And how
indeed.
Much you see?
Yeah, true.
Way bigger. What's all that space for?
Could go deep in the earth.
With what it has to do, it could go thousands of miles below the surface of the planet.
Or completely span it. An underground network.
Wow.
Just a thought, of course. I wouldn't even know where to start hypothesizing how it all works. The remnant builders, whoever, whatever they were, accomplished something far beyond us.
Mm-hmm. All right. Oh.
When did you start believing in a god?
Let's see.
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. Mm-hmm. So when I became a teenager, let's just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
But your work as a scientist
convinced me even more, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks.
Interesting.
God, to me, is an artist. An inventor, not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
I take it you work closely with the Nexus science team?
I try to keep in contact with them. We discuss anything and everything we discover out here.
Good.
After all, many brains are better than one, and Dr. Aridana is worth two or three at least.
Cool.
I work best when I have other people to bounce ideas off of.
Many people do. Andromeda scans?
I'm still fuzzy about how we managed to see Andromeda all the way from home.
Yeah.
It confused me too. I mean, the light lag would have made any data 2 million
yes.
years
how,
out of date.
How do you explain this?
So I asked Dr. Aridana, and she told me, well, it wasn't her tech that did it. It was the guests.
Oh.
You're kidding. Those killer robots we had in the Milky Way?
Those exact ones. The initiative obtained data from an array in deep space. A Geth construct.
Oh.
According to Aridana, the Geth rebuilt a mass relay and turned the approach corridor into an FTL sensor.
Cool.
FTL sensor. So a faster-than-light telescope? They could survey Andromeda as it was?
Not exactly, but it cut down the lag by... enough. We don't
cool.
know why the Geth were interested in observing beyond the galaxy, though. Maybe we'll never know.
Did my dad know about this? Why didn't he tell me?
It's possible he didn't know. The Geth are isolationist and hostile.
Yeah,
using
sure,
the info,
but...
even obtaining it in the first place, probably crossed a lot of boundaries.
Alright, terraforming.
What do you know about the Remnant's terraforming network?
From what I can tell, the vault is designed to adjust almost everything about a planet. Climate,
okay.
pH of the soil, atmosphere composition. There's even evidence that it can propagate life.
Wow.
If we can figure out how to control the vaults, we could turn these worlds into perfect habitats.
Interesting.
What do you
Scourge.
Know about the Scourge?
Scourge. Scourge. Scourge.
Artificial. Someone put it there.
The remnants or someone else?
Something that caused its creation.
Okay.
We don't know why. That's still a mystery.
Alright, let's talk later.
Sounds good.
Alrighty. Okay. So, I still haven't talked to Kello. But I think that's going to have to wait till the next episode, because this is really going too long. So if you've been hanging out for me to talk to Kello, I'm sorry, you'll have to wait a little bit longer. Let me know what you think of people so far in the comments. Who's your favourite companion, person on the Nexus, apart from Kello, obviously, so far? Do let me know. And do give us a thumbs up if you like this video. Please do subscribe. Congratulations to anybody who made it to the end. And I will talk to you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.